But if you want to apply this way of sunnah, the third way, it should be above the navel. Above the navel. طيب. So, after saying Allahu Akbar, this is the first thing you say. You put the right hand on the left hand on the chest. Okay? On the chest. Then, make sure that you lower your gaze down. You lower your gaze, okay? That you look at the place of your sujood. You look at the place of your sujood, okay? Why this is helpful to focus in your salah? Because if you keep praying in this way and you are watching to the right and to the left, you want to check how many mushaf. Sometimes you count how many mushaf in the masjid. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. How many spotlights in the masjid. Okay. But subhanAllah, this will help you. I mean, if you focus on the ground, on the place of your sujood. Okay. The scholars mentioned, what is the proof for that? Something maybe not exactly the same in the salah, but when the Prophet ﷺ entered Mecca, the narrator mentioned that the Prophet ﷺ was looking down as humbleness. So we need to look down during the sujood. And also there is no problem if you need to see the imam. I am praying in the masjid. I am following the imam. Okay? So can I see the imam, what he is doing, how he is doing the takbir, how he is raising the hand, how he is doing the taslim? Yes, this is allowed. This is allowed. How did the companions, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, describe the salah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Because they were watching him during the salah. So this is allowed to see the imam. Okay, for example, I'm behind the imam. I can't see the imam. Okay, I check how he's doing the salah. Okay, so but you not do this every salah, every day, every prayer. Maybe you see him once, twice. Okay, then again you see down. So this is important to help you to focus in the salah, watching, seeing the place of your sujood. So now I put my right hand on left hand, then I start after the takbir saying something called dua al-istiftah. We need to start with dua al-istiftah, I mean after the takbir. A majority scholar said this is recommended, and some scholars said this is wajib, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to one of the companions that your salah will not be acceptable if you don't start after the takbir praising Allah. Okay, so you need to memorize one or more. There are, alhamdulillah, several ahadith, several types of dua. Yani, for example, you can say سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك وتبارك اسمك وتعالى جدك ولا إله غيرك. This is very common dua, and this dua was yes, Umar ibn Khattab رضي الله تعالى told the companions, and he recited this dua loudly. It is allowed. Yeah, for example, you are a teacher for boys, okay, or for girls, okay, in the masjid. I mean a female teacher, you want to teach the students, you can't recite everything loudly to teach them or your children. So Umar radiallahu ta'ala recited this dua loudly. The sunnah, not to raise your voice, but he needs to teach them. So he said, سبحانك اللهم بحمدك وتبارك اسمك وتعالى جدك ولا إله غيرك. Another dua in Bukhari, اللهم باعد بيني وبين خطاياي, or Muslim, اللهم باعد بيني وبين خطاياي كما بعدت بين المشرق والمغرب. اللهم نقيني من خطاياي كما نقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس. اللهم اغسلني من خطاياي بالماء والثلج والبرد. So in one salah you say this dua, and the other salah you say the other dua. Or you say الله أكبر كبيرة والحمد لله كثيرة وسبحان الله بكرة وأصيلة. Okay, so you have several and different types of dua. So it's better to memorize 3 or 4, of course the best to memorize all of them, then you recite them every time, you recite one of them every time in the salah. Don't join two of them. We need only one dua. Here, in this position, only one dua. طيب. After reciting dua al-istiftah, what's in dua al-istiftah? To begin the salah, to start the salah after takbirat al-ihram. After dua al-istiftah, we start to recite al-fatiha. And al-fatiha is one of the pillars in the salah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, la salata liman lam yaqra' bi ummil kitab. There is no valid, it means there is no valid salah for the person who doesn't start, who doesn't recite ummul kitab. It means al-fatiha. Okay, the best surah in the Quran is Surah Al-Fatiha. So you have to recite Surah Al-Fatiha. If you are individual, you are praying alone, or if you are imam. But if you are following the imam, this is a different issue. Some scholars said you have to read, other scholars said you don't have to read. Okay, so if it is Dhuhr, Asr, the third, fourth rak'ah, and Isha, the third rak'ah al-Maghrib, okay, you have to pray because the imam is not reciting loudly. But when the imam is reciting loudly, okay, it is a strong opinion, you listen to him. Listen to the imam. No need for you to recite Surah Al-Fatiha. As I said, this is a controversial issue, okay, very strong, two opinions in this issue. So basically, reciting Fatiha is compulsory, is one of the pillars of the Salah. Because it is a pillar in the Salah, you need to learn how to recite Surah Al-Fatiha. You need to learn how to recite Surah Al-Fatiha. Of course, as a general recommendation, we recite A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitan Rajim. Okay, this is mustahab, according to the majority of scholars, before reciting anything from the Quran in the salah or outside the salah. Okay, so the sunnah that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was reciting A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim. How? He was saying A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim min hamzihi wa nafkhihi wa nafthihi. Or A'udhu billahi as-sami' al-alim minash shaitan rajim min hamzihi wa nafkhihi wa nafthihi. Okay, sorry brothers sisters, I will not explain the dua, because this needs another lectures. Okay, we need other lectures to explain all the types of dua. What is the meaning of Allahu Akbar? What is the meaning of A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitan Rajeem? What is the meaning of Subhan Rabbi Al-A'la? Okay, here in this course or this workshop, I like to explain what is the way or what is the correct way of performing the salah as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prayed. So you say A'udhu Billahi Minash Shaitan Rajeem min hamzihi wa nafkhihi wa nafthihi. Then you recite Surah Al-Fatiha. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Okay. Some scholars said Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is one verse from the Fatiha. Other scholars said no, it is not a verse. Shaykh al-Albani rahimahullah mentioned a hadith that Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is one of the verses of Surah Al-Fatiha. So make sure that you recite Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. You say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. Okay. Ameen is not part of Surah Al-Fatiha, but the Sunnah, after reciting Surah Al-Fatiha, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was saying Ameen. Okay, make sure how to pronounce. If there is Shadda, for example, Iyaka, not Iyaka. Make sure Iyaka na'budu wa Iyaka nasta'in. Make sure the Mad to extend the letter. Walad-dallin. Okay, make sure this. Brothers, sisters, we are praying every day. So take time to learn the salah. Practice. And alhamdulillah, now it is much easier than before. You can check the YouTube. You can check with imam, with muaddin, or with hafiz to teach you how to recite Surah Al-Fatiha. So after reciting Surah Al-Fatiha, you say, Ameen. Okay, if you are praying also in jama'ah, listen to the imam. If the imam finished reciting al-fatiha, then you say Ameen. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا قَالَ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ قُولُوا آمِينَ. So after he finished وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ, then we say Ameen. Don't be hurry. Don't think that, wallah, if I say it quickly, I will finish the salah before the imam. You cannot leave the salah before the imam. You have to wait until the imam gives the salam. Okay, so wait the imam. When he finishes the وَلَا الضَّالِّينَ, then you say Ameen. Okay, and others said, you have to wait until the imam say Ameen, then you say Ameen after him. طيب. So this is one of the pillars of the salah, saying, reciting Surah Al-Fatiha. After reciting Surah Al-Fatiha, it is sunnah to recite another surah. Okay, of course, many Muslims think that it should be short surah. Okay, no, it should not be short surah. It can be long surah. يعني for example, Mu'adh bin Jabal رضي الله تعالى recited Surah Al-Baqarah in العشاء صلاة. Okay, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم one time, there is one, in one hadith, he recited Surah Al-A'raf in المغرب صلاة. Can you imagine Surah Al-A'raf? About juz, more than 20 pages or about around 20 pages, depends which kind of mushaf you have. Okay, so we'll say that it is sunnah to recite Surah after Al-Fatiha. And it is sunnah to recite the full surah, not part of the surah. Okay, if you recite part of the surah, no problem. Your salah is valid, not haram. But it's better to recite the full surah. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recommended the authentic hadith mentioned by Shaykh Al-Bayr rahimahullah in his book Sifat Salatul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. طيب. Should the imam stop between the Fatiha and the surah to give us the chance to recite Surah Al-Fatiha? This is not sunnah. This is not sunnah. After the imam finished, Ameen, should he pause? He gives us the chance. This is not sunnah. But he needs to stop sometimes just to think what to recite or just to take a breath. Ameen. Just to take a breath, okay? This is no problem. There is no problem, okay? Also, he can stop after reciting the other surah before the ruku', okay? As Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah mentioned, liyatarad ilayhi nafas, also for the breathing, okay? فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ إِنَّ شَانِئَكَ هُوَ الْأَبْتَرُ. Allahu Akbar. Okay, so now after reciting Al-Fatiha, we'll go to the ruku'. We'll go to the ruku'. And for going to the ruku', we need to say Allahu Akbar, and also we raise the hand. The same way. Raising the hand, the same way. Allahu Akbar. Or with the ruku', or yani, before the ruku' or with the ruku', raising the hands. طيب. So now, inshallah, let's try. So now I'm standing in a standing position. Okay, I am holding my left hand with the right hand. طيب. So I finished the surah, reciting the surah. And as I said, it is sunnah, it is not wajib, it is not compulsory to recite the surah. I mean, you can go directly to the ruku' after the Fatiha. Okay, no problem. Okay, if you do that, your salah is valid. So I finished now the surah, or I want to make ruku' after the Fatiha, after saying Ameen. Allahu Akbar. Let's put my ghutra. The back. Again. I'm looking down. Okay. Because of the filming, that's why I'm looking at the camera. Okay. My vision should, my sight should be down. Okay. But just I'm watching the camera. So now I'm going to the ruku'. Allahu Akbar. Try your best. To make your back straight with your head. Okay? Try your best to make your back straight with your head. طيب. And hold your knees with your fingers. As the companions described that, كالقابض عليهما, was holding his knees. And even they describe that even if you pour the water on the back of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the water will not fall. It means his back was straight, and also his head was at the same level with his back. لم يشخصه ولم يصوبه. It was not down or up. Okay, so try your best to make your back straight with your head. This way. Maybe you need someone sometimes to tell you that it is straight, just for one time or two times, then inshallah forever until your salah, your back will be straight. طيب. We said Allahu Akbar and we raised the hands the same way, up to the level of your ears or the shoulders. Now in the ruku', the ruku', of course, it is one of the pillars. It is one of the pillars. And we say adhkar in the ruku'. What to say in the ruku'? طيب, we say Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. Okay? How many times? There is hadith that 3 times. There is another hadith, it is about 10 times. About 10 times. Why? Because they estimated the companions for the Prophet ﷺ saying Subhana Rabbi al-Azim and Subhana Rabbi al-Azim 10 times. He did not say them loudly, so they estimate the time. Can I say Subhana Rabbi al-Azim one time? Yes, it is enough. Can I say more than 10 times? Yes. Because in some hadith that the Prophet ﷺ prolonged the ruku', maybe 20 times or 50, 70 times. Okay? Of course, if you are praying alone, okay, but if you are praying jama'ah, try to make it reasonable for the people, because some of them are sick, some of them are old, like that, some of them busy. So try to make sure that it is suitable for everyone in the masjid. So you say al-adhkar fi ruku'. And the same thing, alhamdulillah, that we have several types of dua or adhkar in the ruku'. Subhana Rabbi al-Azim, and you repeat this, or you can say Subbuh Quddus Rabbul Malaikati wal Ruh, or you say Subhana Dil Jabaruti wal Malakuti wal Kibriya wal Azama. Okay, there are several types of dua. Here Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah mentioned that you can join more than one dua or one dhikr, not like the opening of the salah. The opening of the salah, we said only one dhikr. Why? Because there is hadith that the companions asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, O Rasulullah, before reciting the Fatiha, there is very short pause. You stop for a short time without saying anything. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told them, because I was saying the dua of the istiftah, of the opening of the salah. So that's why for the salah, opening of the salah, you say only one dhikr. You choose only one. But for the ruku', and also the same thing in the sujood, you can combine more than one or more than two. You can say Subhan Rabbi al-Azim, Subhan Rabbi al-Azim, Subhan Rabbi al-Azim, Subbuh, Quddus, Rabbul Malaikati wal Ruh, Subhan Dhil Jabaruti wal Malkuti wal Kibriya wal Azama, and you repeat them. Okay, you say that in the ruku'. But you have to avoid the Quran. You have to avoid reciting the Quran. Ali radiallahu ta'ala said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam forbade me to recite the Quran while bowing or prostrating in the ruku' or in the sujood. Don't recite the Quran. Okay, don't recite the Quran in the ruku' or in the sujood. Okay, so in the ruku', as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَمَّا الرُّكُوع فَعَظِّمُوا, glorify, عَظِّمُوا فِيهِ الرَّبِّ, glorify your Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala. وأما السجود فأكثروا فيه من الدعاء. In the sujood, make a lot of dua. طيب, can you make dua in the ruku'? Yes, you can make. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. سبحانك اللهم ربنا وبحمدك اللهم اغفر لي. Oh Allah, forgive me. طيب, so you can make. But mainly the dua should be for the sujood. And in the ruku', glorify Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So now you are in the ruku' position. After the ruku', you stand up again. Sami'allahu liman hamidah.
Again, I'm in the ruku' position. Then I stand up. سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ. So, while moving from the ruku' position to the standing position, you say, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ. Okay? I'm emphasizing this. Why? Because many Muslims, in this way, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ. Okay? They say, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ when they are fully in upright position. You should say, or the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to say سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ when you are shifting from the ruku' position to the standing position. طيب. So you say سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ. Then you stand up. So standing up after the ruku', this is also one of the pillars. This is one of the pillars. It is not allowed to go directly to the sujood. You have to stand up. Then you go to the sujood position. Okay? Again, you are in the ruku' position. Say, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ. Then when you are fully standing up, you say another dhikr, رَبَّنَا وَلَكَ الْحَمْدِ. Or you say, اللَّهُمَّ رَبَّنَا وَلَكَ الْحَمْدِ. Okay? You have also more than type of dhikr. Okay? You can choose any one of them. طيب. So, while standing, while moving, you say, سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَهُ. When you are fully in a standing position, you say, رَبَّنَا وَلَكَ الْحَمْدِ. If you like, you can add, حَمْدًا كَثِيرًا طَيِّبًا مُبَارَكًا فِيهِ. Also, there is another dua or dhikr. So now I raised my hands. Okay, now this is the third position. I raised my hands at the beginning of the salah for takbiratul ihram, and this is a pillar. I mean, saying takbiratul ihram, but raising the hand is sunnah. Again, the second time I raised my hands when I went for ruku'. The third time when I raised my back, when you rise from the ruku', also you raise your hands. Okay, hadith authentic in Bukhari and Muslim. So up to here we have three places to raise your hands. And you say, رَبَّنَا وَلَكَ الْحَمْدِ. طيب. Where to keep your hands after the ruku'? Where to keep your hands after the ruku'? طيب. Most of the scholars say you release your hands, you keep them down. Okay? And few scholars said you keep your hands up, like before the ruku'. Imam Ahmed, rahimahullah ta'ala, you know, Imam Ahmed al-Hanbal, said if you keep your hands at the same position or you release them, this is okay and this is okay. Okay? Why? Because the hadith is not clearly saying you keep your hands on the chest or down. So you do this or that, this is okay. But as I said, most of the scholars said, you release your arms down. Okay? Brothers, sisters, we like to take a break for just 5 minutes and we'll come back, inshallah.